The one and only Mr. Ronnie Twist. Come on, let's hear it. Come on, Ron, my babe.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. A great pleasure to be here at the Downtown Restaurant. I was standing over by the bar after desperately trying for about 20 minutes to get a drink, listening to the dulcet tones of Mr. Lee Tracy. And I remember thinking how smart he looked, and I'm glad I wore my best suit. Do you like the suit, madam? Unexpected present from the wife. Got home early last night, was hanging over a chair in the bedroom. That's great, you know. I arrived changed tonight because it's rather dangerous to be out in the streets these days with a bow tie and a frilly shirt. People get the wrong impression, don't they, sir? I was in this club and the police raided it, you see. Never pinched anybody, got £1.50 each for their truncheons. Wasn't really worth the effort, was it? But I remember thinking it's a funny thing about puffs, considering they don't reproduce, there's thousands of them. I was thinking, can I have a guess at somebody's occupation? And you've been elected, sir. Is that a pattern on your tie? You've been sick, down it. Oh, that's a pet. Can I have a guess at your occupation? Well, smile then. I'm getting the distinct impression with a little bit of practice, you could be fucking unpleasant, you know what I mean? Sitting here looking at me, you know. I'll get round to you in a minute. Here's a fella come home from work very early one night, and he said to his wife, I feel sexy tonight. He said, you and me upstairs in the shower, 68. She said, what's the 68? He said, you suck mine, I know you one. Now. I love that. Great game, that. Says, I'll throw one in for the kids, you know what I mean? Fella walked into the bathroom. I'll stick with a quick joke to get back to you later, so I'm getting more laughs on my own. Fella walked into his bathroom, sitting in the bath, you see, it was his little son, about 14 years old, playing with himself. And the fella was very upset. Now, I personally wouldn't have been upset myself, because I do think there's nothing wrong in playing with yourself. Thank God, make you be a better class of people that way. This fella was very upset. He said to his son, don't do that, son, it makes your ears go red. And the kid said, come on, Dad, that don't make your ears go red. He said, it does if you do it in my fucking bathroom. Two Irish fellas walking down this dark country lane, 2 o'clock in the morning, picture the scene, freezing cold, blowing like the devil and pouring down with rain. And Pat says to Mick, Mick, the next time we're in a car with two girls and you say it's either sex or walk, make sure it's our car. Sorry, I should have done the old one about the Irish fella killed his wife, put her in a bath of acid and burnt his right arm off pulling a plug. I don't know why we bother with the new jokes, do you? I always laugh at the old ones, don't they? Right, lads, I'm going to try something here tonight since I'm first on. I've got everything going and nothing to lose. So, can you give me a little bit of sort of ghostly music? I want to do something. Two old maids asleep in a haunted house on the M1. On this terrible evening, when the wind was howling. It's a bit basic, but I'll take it, mate. I'm desperate. The rain was lashing down.
It's a bat.
You're taking a piss, aren't you, mate? The thunder was crashing.
Bang.
Don't give up your day job, mate. We're not there. And the lightning was flashing. Oh, dear. And the two old maids lay snoring. All of a sudden, down in the hall, a clock was ticking, and out through the window, an owl hooted. This owl had a hernia. Or would have if he don't hoot properly. All of a sudden, the door creaked open. I thought he was going to be sick, really. Into the room floated a ghostly apparition of a handsome young man. He floated into the room, went up to the bed, leaned over the two old maids, and went hocus pocus, hocus pocus. One old maid opened one eye and said, never mind the hocus. That's the end of that, fellas, actually. who was a long green man in a shop with an old green door. He and all lay all in a way, and it really made me sore. He lost his heart to a Chinese girl, now the laundry's all gone wrong. All day he'll flirt, scorch a shirt, and that's why I'm singing this song. Mr. Wu, what can I do? I've got this kind of life of Chinese laundry blues. That funny feeling keeps round me stealing. Why don't you throw your sweetheart overdue? Now Mr. Wu, he's got a funny eye that flickers. You ought to see it wobble when he's ironing ladies' blouses, Mr. Wu. What can I do? I've got those kind of limehouse Chinese laundry blues. Oh, now every night when the sun goes down, stars begin to peep, you'll find there's a kind of mystery round the old green door will creep. There's Mr. Wu, Chinese girl with a pipe and a bottle of wine, while the laundry's getting soaking wet, hanging on the old back line. Oh, Mr. Wu, what can I do? I've got those kind of limehouse Chinese laundry blues. That funny feeling keeps round me stealing. Why don't you throw your sweetheart overdue? My vest's so short that it won't fit my little brother. My new Sunday shirt's got a perforated rudder, Mr. Wu. What can I do? I've got those kind of limehouse Chinese. Here comes the clever bit. Flickers, you ought to see it wobble when he's ironing ladies' blouses, Mr. Wu. What can I do? I've got this kind of limehouse Chinese laundry blues. I'm a favourite of yours and mine. I'm glad I met you. And it goes like this. La, 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 la. I'm leaning on a lap. Maybe you think I look a trap, or you may think I'm hanging round to steal a car. But no, I'm not a crook, and if you think that's what I look, I'll tell you why I'm here and what my motives are. I'm leaning on a lamppost at the corner of the street in case a certain little lady comes by. Oh me, oh my, I hope that little lady comes by, for there's no other girl I would wait for. But this one I'd break any date for. I don't have to ask what she's late for. She wouldn't leave me flat. She's not a girl like her lad. She's absolutely wonderful, marvelous, she's beautiful. Anyone can understand why I'm leaning on a lamppost at the corner of the street in case a certain little lady comes by. Because I'm leaning on a lamppost at the corner of the street in case a certain little lady comes by. Oh me, oh my, I hope that little lady comes by, for there's no other girl I would wait for. But this one I'd break any day for. I don't have to ask what she's late for. She wouldn't believe me flat, she's not a girl like that. She's absolutely wonderful, she's marvelous, she's beautiful. Anyone can understand why I'm leaning on a lamppost at the corner of the street. Everybody clap now, cos you're on television.
The fabulous Ronnie Combat, Ronnie Swiss, Ronnie Swiss, and of course Ronnie Swiss there, and his partner.